I can't help but reflect back on April 1st, 2006, where God allowed me to birth Rhema Word Ministry. We birthed it in the Comfort Inn Hotel of Oxmoor. And it was there where we only had two members. The sad thing about it is that those two members had to work some weekends. And so that left me preaching to the chairs. And so bringing in the equipment, the mics, the speakers, the amps, I only find out no one was there but me. So I had to preach to the chairs. So I did the offering, I did praise and worship, I did everything, and no one came in but me and God. And I left there sad, wanting to give up, because what God called me to, it seemed as if it wasn't working in the beginning, but I pressed. Through much prayer and dedication, church began to grow. People started coming. But I must say that it took at least a couple of months before the first person actually came and joined the church, after the two members were already there. And it was hard. The room that we started in was very small. And you can get, 10 chairs on the right-hand side and 10 on the left-hand side. So, you get 8 people in there, you had a packed church. That's how small the room was. We had our first baptism. Maybe like 8 months later, our first baptism. And being that I didn't have a baptism pool or a church, and so I was at the hotel, and God showed me the swimming pool outside. So our very first baptism was in the swimming pool. Our second baptism, we baptized 13 of our members at the time. They all got baptized, and some got rebaptized in the swimming pool. You weren't swimming, they got baptized in the swimming pool. So things like that that I really have to reflect on. And in November 2007, a year and a half later, we've outgrown the hotel. Now we're looking for a place, looking for a building. And there behold, our first move was in Kingston. It was a garage, it wasn't a church. And so we had to go in and remodel. God said, I make room for your gift. He didn't say how the room would look. So he made room. He made room for the gift. And we went in, and God blessed us to have working people at the church. So we turned a garage into a sanctuary. And we got the building, and ministry began to grow. We was doing awesome things, doing plays. What have you, name it, we was prospering, doing well. Until that night, 2008, I'll never forget. I was actually floored. That night, I'll never forget. I'm up teaching, and while I'm teaching, the lights start flickering in the sanctuary. And while the lights begin to flicker in the sanctuary, I'm thinking the AC just surging. But it kept doing it randomly. And so as we closed service out, to our surprise, we walked outside, building on fire. The fire department came. They came, and long story short, they pulled the meter away from the building and told us that we have to get the whole building rewired. And so here we are, going fine, everything going good, until the fire came. When the fire came, we had to have service outside. It's 120 degrees. We had service outside. We had Bible study outside. There was no place for us to go. We were somewhat homeless as a church. And I seen the membership just begin to dwindle because we had nowhere to go. And so now we looking to go back to the hotel, trying to find a room. And sadly, we went back to the Comfort Inn. We went to every hotel in Birmingham. And just like Jesus, there was no room in the inn. And fortunately, 3 weeks later, the Howard Johnson in Homewood called us back, and they had a space. Went back to the hotel. Now we're back in the place where we started. Now I've watched 120 people dwindled down to 110, 95, 65, 75. I'm watching the praise team leave, secretary leave, leaders leave. And it got to the point where it dwindled down to just 7 people. Offerings gone. I mean, it's to the point where I'm devastated. I'm ready to quit. I'm ready to throw in the towel. And it was at that point where I thought that what God promised me wouldn't come to pass. But it was during that storm in 2008 where God was building me up as a pastor. God was letting me know that he that begun a good work shall complete until the day of Christ. So the whole summer we in a hotel, not in our building. But it was right when we were in that hotel where God began to send good leaders and good people. So everything that we lost, we started to get it back in the fire. See, most people get it back after the fire, but we started to get it back in the fire. And God began to build me back in the fire. And so after the storm, we got our building back. Membership increase almost doubled. And so in 2010, Raymond Word Livingston was birthed. It was birthed in 2010. And we thank God for that church down there. I mean, out of the storm, little did I know God was birthing something else, you know. And then we began to grow and grow and grow, and it got to the point where we needed more space. And so God gave me a vision to increase and larger territory. And here we are outside digging a foundation, trying to at least make space for 80 more people, cutting down trees, laying foundation to make space just for 80 more people until God said, take the limits off. And so here we are now, the greater. God will always make room. Had I quit back in 2008, we wouldn't be where we are today.
For grace, for faith.